Thank you. As Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed.
Jesus said, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me.
I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
If we live, we live to the Lord. If we die, we die to the Lord. For whether we die, we are the Lord's, for the both of the dead and of the living.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? From you alone, O Lord, our sins are justly angered. Holy God, holy and mighty, Holy Immortal One, have mercy upon us.
Kindly be seated for an appreciation given by Commander Dave Dowage.
Good morning. Like a comet blazing across the evening sky, gone too soon. Born to amuse, to inspire, to delight, here one day, gone one night. When I received the news on the 25th of January, that my friend of over 40 years had passed. The lyrics of the song written by Michael Jackson for a young friend who had passed came immediately to me. Though the circumstances of Ambrose's passing was a little different, I thought that a number of the stanzas and the course were at. You see, Ambrose was something of a comet. He blazed a career in the Barbados Defense Force. He was, as Brigadier Lewis described him, a gladiator. He stood tall in any company. Cricket, motor transport, he stood tall. He had a presence. He had significant oratorical skills. He read a lot, and he spoke of what he read. And he didn't necessarily wait for you to ask him to speak. He in fact spoke on any topic at length, and he spoke well. He was a socialite. He walked among kings and servants, seniors, juniors, and peers alike, in the messes, on the parade square, in the rum shop, in the pavilion. He fitted in comfortably with all. He was contented and unpretentious. Ambrose was the type of person that could talk his way into any promotion, and if he wanted to be a warrant officer, an officer, a captain, a major, I'm sure, with his ability to speak, he could convince anyone. But he knew his place, and he knew where he could contribute best, and he was always contented and never overly ambitious. He was a gentleman, a consummate gentleman, very, very respectful. He knew, again, how to treat his officers, his peers, and his juniors. He knew how to treat them and anyone there, particularly as a sportsman. One person could well be his officer, his teammate, peer, or his junior. And he could move between all three phases easily. He was, among all, a friend of many people. Ambrose Sarfraz Nawaz was classy. He dressed well. He wore, when he played cricket for the Barbados Defence Force, a short sleeve, sweater, pullover, which he no doubt convinced a visiting member of a British team to give him. He was that type of person, you know, he would make friends and get a whole heap of things from our visiting friends. But he wore it with class. He dressed the part. He looked like a test player whenever he took the field. Unless he was bowling and the red streak on his trousers made him look a little untidy. You know, but he looked the part in whatever he did. When he batted, many argued that his cover drive was similar to that of a Carl Hooper. Classy. It is a pity, though, that he had something in common with Carl Hooper, because he never lasted very long. Ambrose, my friend, made some good choices. Probably one of the most important choices outside of joining the Barbados Defence Force was in selecting Julia to be his wife. Now, let me make it clear. Julia is from the Bialan. Julia is a Banfield. And we were very envious and indeed upset that a man coming all the way from St. George could come and steal one of our best and most beautiful people, which we considered to be our own in the Bialan. No doubt Julia could look at him eye to eye when he stood tall, because she wasn't the shortest girl. Ambrose made a contribution to the development of young players. People like Floyd Weaver from here in St. George, Campbell, and many others benefited from the knowledge and which he was willing to impart. He organized many a cricket game, and he made sure he had the attention of many of these young players after the game was done, sometimes into the wee hours of the night. Then, of course, he made sure they got home safely. Was collectively the showed all the tenets, all the good tenets of being a military man, prompt, timely, obedient, hardworking. Sarfraz, to all, was a gentleman of all things. He was my friend. And as the sun sets to make way for the rising of the moon, gone too soon. But rest assured, my friend, your legacy will live on through us all. Rest in peace and rise in glory.
Please remain seated as the eulogy is given by WR1 Cheryl Deane.
Good morning to all. I recognize the presence of all dignitaries here this morning, including my parliamentary representative, the Honorable Dwight Sutherland, Commander Durridge, Commandant of the Barbados Cadet Corps, Colonel Glenn Granham, former Chief of Staff of the Barbados Defense Force, and Lieutenant Colonel John Nurse, former Commanding Officer of the Regiment, and all others who are gathered here, as we give thanks and praise to Almighty God for the life, work, witness of a dearly departed husband, father, brother, uncle, and friend. Ambrose, Harold, Elvin, Deane. Known to many of us as Sarfraz Naraz or Led Hutton. Born to the late Harold Deane and Joyce Marshall Deane, he was the second of three boys in the Union. Michael predeceased him in 2018. He was born at Superlative St. George and had attended the St. Luke's Boys' School, Parkinson Secondary School, and the then Samuel Jackman Prescott Polytechnic, now the Samuel Jackman Institute of Science and Technology, where he later taught. But who is Ambrose Harold Deane, that so many of you are gathered here, both on the inside and the outside, to pay respect to and to mourn with the family? I will best describe him as having a colorful and entertaining life, a number of dear friends, full of chat and witty. Our mother called him Elvin, not sure why. He spent his formative years in Superlative, where he learned the skills of being a mechanic with a guy called Freddy, and his tiling skills with Nuts Miller. Mr. Eswick from the Mount Hill thought that he could be a good fast bowler and called him Led Hutton. Others saw the skills in him and called him Sarfraz. As my bigger brother, we had a good childhood relationship, doing all the things of our era would normally do in the community. Church at St. Luke's on Sundays, church at the Mount Hill Church of the Nazarene during the week, playing cricket, you know the thing. After a short stint at Intel on the Harbour Road, he joined the then Barbados Regiment in 1977. And with the formation of the Barbados Defense Force in 1979, enlisted on the 11th of November 1979 and was given the service number 7920236. Ambrose served with distinction until 2010 on reaching the age of 55, a period of 31 years of distinction. He served in motor transport, works troop, and as a clerk. He represented the BDF in cricket and squash. He could best be described as one of the better clerks the BDF ever had. Very meticulous in every detail. A Trinidadian Calypsonian once said, "Show me the corner and I will make the suit to fit." Ambrose was like that man. Working as guard commander or as duty corporal, he just had to see you coming to sign out and would say, "Carry on, laddie. I have your number, rank, and name." He knew just about every soldier in the BDF's number and just about everything about you. As I said earlier, he was very detailed in his work and often assisted officers in their staff duties. Once based at Harrison Point, Ambrose had just left the base and was driving on that long stretch of road, fast as usual. He took a corner and did not like how it was done and decided to try again. He did, but ended up with a broken foot. Then the car crashed. In 1979, he took his sweetheart friend, Julia Banfield, to be his dear wife. The union produced one daughter. Ambrose was always immaculately dressed and ensured that his daughter, Leah, was also well turned out for school in her uniform. In fact, he was responsible for washing and pressing her uniform and ensuring that her shoes were always shining. Once on an FSM's drill parade, he would always boast that he had to look good so as not to disappoint his younger brother, who at the time was the four-star major. When the parade was formed up and during inspection, he was usually the first to be sent off. Not that he was in bad order or anything, but it was simply that he was my bigger brother. He was always one to pass on knowledge to others. Ambrose served in Grenada, Haiti, Jamaica, Montserrat. He once told an officer who was present and who thought he was a chef while serving in Montserrat to leave the kitchen as he could not cook or boil water. Ambrose ended up doing cooking duties. In Grenada, he taught me the ins and outs and the do's and don'ts of life in an area of operation. For his service to the BDF, he was awarded the Services Medal of Honor, the RSS Medal, and the General Service Medal of two class. Ambrose loved reading and was a bookstore for knowledge. And it was not only the Hardy Boys or the Nancy Drew books, but books like The Guns of Navarone, For Stand from Navarone, with writers like Alistair MacLean, who in one of his books remarked that men who wear dark shades saw things darkly. He had a cross-section of friends who would borrow books from him, and he did it likewise. I stated earlier that he attended the Church of the Nazarene at Monk Hill. Ambrose was a fiery preacher at that church. Reverend Nigel Newton could always count on him to lead church and to bring a word. In later times, he attended a church in Britain's Hill at the Bonnets Resources Center, and there his pastor, Reverend Ewell Clark, who, by the way, was a member of the BDF, saw the other side of Ambrose. Once, well, having a conversation with a dear lady friend of his, her father came out and asked him, "What are your intentions?" Ambrose simply stated, "To get up from here, I'm going to catch the bus and go home." End of story. Ambrose was by no means St. Ambrose of Milan or St. Paul or even St. Peter. Like all of us, he had his shortcomings, and his wife and daughter remembers his saying, "Lord, be merciful to me, a poor criminal like me." His wife remembers him as a great cook when he took his time, and his daughter as one who she loved to play with. As I said earlier, he taught at the Samuel Jackman Institute of Science and Technology, and again was a true representative of the BDF, always early for classes, well turned out, pants pressed, and pull above waist. 1 week before he died, he turned to his dear wife and said, "Julia, I love you." And her reply was, "I love you too." Ambrose and I had a long conversation at home on Thursday, the 25th of January, at approximately 13:15 hours. I left him in his chair, resting. At approximately 18:30 hours, his wife called me to say that she had come home and found him laying on the ground and not responding. I told her, "I'm on my way." Funeral services offer us the opportunity to reflect on our own mortal lives and to ask the question, if death should come our way, are we prepared for it? As we gather here to pay our last respects to a family man and colleague, we must ask ourselves this question. What positive lessons can we take away from Ambrose's life to help us along our Christian journey? Be true to your God. Be loyal to your organization. Be committed and dedicated to your family. Stand up for what is right. Recognize that as humans, we will fall, and always lean on Almighty God for guidance. Today, the BDF cricketers will pay their last respect to the departed brother by forming a guard of honor as the mortal remains goes to its final resting place. The Barbados Legion will pay their respect by sounding the last post to indicate to us that it is time for him to rest from a day's work. This will be followed by the reveille to remind us that life goes on. And what about us gathered here? As we say thank you, Sergeant Ambrose, Harold, Elvin, Deane, Sarfraz, Naraz, or Led Hutton, for your life among us, for your work as a soldier, and to your national development, and in the words of St. Paul, you have fought a good fight. You have finished the course. Thanks for your love and support to him, and in particular to you, Julia, for the love you shared through it all. In closing, I say, may the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs receive you at your coming and lead you into the holy city, Jerusalem. May the choir of angels receive you, and with Lazarus, who was once poor, may you have everlasting rest. So long, my brother. Goodbye. Until we meet.
We will now have a solo by Kenneth Armstrong.
Tis grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relief. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believe. Too many dangers, toils, and snares I have already come. Your grace has brought me safe this far, and your grace will lead me home.
Your Holy Son, no sin to hide, but you have brought me to your side to be led by your staff and rod, and to be called the Lamb of God. Your gift of love they crucified, they laughed and scorned him as he died. The humble king the name of fraud, and sacrificed the Lamb of God. O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb, of God. You wash me in your precious blood. My Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love that holy Lamb of God. You wash me in your precious blood. My Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. I was so lost, I should have died. But you have brought me to your side, to be led by your staff and rod, and to be called the Lamb of God. O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, oh, how I love that Lamb of God. You wash me in your precious blood. My Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God, O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love that holy Lamb of God. You wash me in your precious blood. By Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. My Jesus Christ, you're my Lamb of God. My Jesus Christ, you're my Lamb of God.
Amen. Amen.
Please stand as we sing the hymn 689.
And we pray that, having opened to him the gates of larger life, you will receive him more and more into your joyful service, that, with all who have served you in the past, he may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of the first scripture reading by Shanice Banfield.
Good morning. A reading from the lesson of Paul to Timothy, chapter 4, verse 1 to 8. In the presence of God and of Jesus Christ, who is to judge the living and the dead, and in the view of his appearing and his kingdom, I solemnly urge you, proclaim the message. Be persistent whether the time is favorable and unfavorable. Convince, rebuke, and encourage with the utmost patience in teaching. For the time is coming when people will not put up with the sound of doctrine, but having itching ears, they will accumulate for themselves teachers to suit for their own desires, and will turn away from listening to the truth and wander away to myths. As for you, always be sober, endure suffering, do the work of an evangelist, carry out your mystery fully. As for me, I am ready, being poured out as a liberation, and the time of my departure has come. I have fought the good fight. I have finished the race. I have kept the faith. From now on, there is served for me the crown of righteousness, which the Lord, thy righteous judge, will give to me on that day, and not only to me, but also to who have longed for his appearing. This is the word of the Lord.
Please remain seated as the choir leads us in Psalm number 23.
Thank you. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 12th chapter beginning at the 35th verse. Let your waist be girded and your lamps burning, and you yourselves be like men who wait for their master when he will return from the wedding, that when he comes and knocks, they may open to him immediately. Blessed are those servants whom the master, when he comes, will find watching. Assuredly, I say to you that he will gird himself and have them sit down to eat and will come and serve them. And if he should come in the second watch or come in the third watch and find them so, blessed are those servants. But know this, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would not have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour you do not expect. This is the Gospel of Christ.
Please stand as we sing the hymn 427. Through all the changing scenes of life.
Thank you. hold it up. When we die and leave these finite bodies, we will have a wonderful resurrection body in heaven. God made, not fashioned by human hands. And we will never have to relocate our tents again. Our new home will be ours forevermore. Words found in 2 Corinthians, the 5th verse. May I speak to you in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. The muffled drum, sad roll, has beat the soldier's last tattoo. No more on life parade shall meet that brave and fallen few. On fame's eternal camping ground, their silent tents are spread. But glory guards with solemn dignity the bevought of the dead. Was written by Theodore O'Hara in the year 1847. Can anything be more ironic than the life of our nation's military? They love their country and people, so they spend long years giving of their service. And then after retirement from active duty, they still offer themselves to the legionnaires. They are involved with their colleagues at functions, formal and informal. They are on parades or at the inevitable funeral of one of their colleagues. They revere freedom, yet they sacrifice their own so that others may be free. They defend their own right to live as individuals, yet yield their individuality in that cause. Perhaps, most paradoxically of all, they value life, yet so bravely they are ready themselves to die for others. Today, we like Ambrose have come to honor our own. We stand to honor him, to say God to him, we stand to honor him today and to say thanks to God for what he meant to us. We do not stand in judgment, for like us, he was not perfect, but he used his gifts and skills to share and help others. Yes, we stand to sound the last post for one of ours, whose tent has been stricken for the last time on earth. Ambrose loved the army. I remember when he joined. It was all the school days, and he went to recruitment while I went to college. But our friendships remained strong. And I want to say here that sometimes brothers get stories wrong. And Cheryl was my big brother, so I'm going to clarify that this morning in a few moments. Many Fridays when he came from Harrison's base up St. Lucie, he would stop to say hello to my brother and I. And we were always happy to hear the stories about army life. Carefree, looking to establish ourselves in our chosen careers. This was okay over the years. and the visit only stopped when on one of his usual quick stop to say hello to the family, that my dad, who was a senior officer in the prison at that time, came out from the bedroom on hearing his voice as usual at the door. That was as far as he would go, not having time to sit and chat, maybe to swallow a little juice that mommy would give him. Yes, fellas, he drank juice also. And as usual, Ambrose braced up and spoke to my dad as was the custom. However, that evening, in a very serious matter-of-fact voice, my dad noticed that this young man was coming to the bailout very regular and could not understand why. Well, I know why, because I know the Banfield girls. We all grew up in the same area, so he was surveying. He was doing a recce. So then my dad said, young man, what are your intentions in this area? This took Ambrose by surprise. And with his usual quick, witty reply, he goes to say goodnight, sir. And with that, he was through the gate, into the vehicle, and gone. Now, Cheryl, you have the story right now. That was the only time I saw fear in my good friend's eyes and a quick action. For Ambrose was never the one to be fearful. He would stand his ground and anger even if he was wrong. Our paths crossed again when I joined the force via the cadet corps. He then became my big brother, who looked out for me. I remember one particular young man who lived in the same area as he did, had his eyes on me. And Ambrose threatened the fellow that if he stepped out of line, he would have to answer to him. This morning, my brothers and sisters, I stand here to say farewell to a friend, a gentleman, and a brother. And as we reflect on the scriptures, may it be to us what is needed at this time of loss. In the Bible, God is often referred to as the Lord of hosts. This word host means army. God is our heavenly commander. Jesus had an encounter with a soldier, a Roman centurion, who asked him to heal a servant. And Jesus said, he's not seen in any faith such as this in all Israel. I like to think that soldiers are especially capable of trusting their chain of command. And that is why when Lieutenant Commander Dorish had a little word with him about Julia, he trusted the words and advice given. And today they're married and have their daughter and many years together. But I am also seeing a lasting trust in God that prevails throughout the years, in times of great strife and in times of peace, in the good times and the bad. And our brother and friend knew that. Those who spend time in military service have an uncomfortable life. At times, we begin to think that being miserable is part of the mission. Field duty is usually an ordeal. Eating the sea rations, cleaning weapons, guard duties, braving the harsh elements, long hours, people who are not thankful, but yet we must answer the call to help. Living in tents or under bush and trees while others are safe in their homes. The Apostle Paul never served in the military, but as a tent maker, he knew what it was like to live a nomadic life under harsh conditions. Thus it is expressed in the verse that I shared with you at the beginning. We know that when this tent we live in is taken down and folded up, when we die and leave these finite bodies, we will have a wonderful new resurrection body in heaven. Therefore, for our troops on deployment, a tent is frequently home sweet home. It's all part of military duty. But no one likes to live permanently in a tent. It may seem like it at times, but the truth of the matter is that at the end of every field exercise, the soldier returned to barrack or headquarters, not to a tent. This is exactly the word picture Paul is presenting to us today. Paul is saying to us that our bodies are like tents. They provide a place to live, but only for a brief moment of our existence. Like the canvas of a tent, our flesh is just temporary structure. And Paul's idea of death is breaking down a tent and folding it up in preparation for moving into a permanent facility. My brother and friend has folded his tent. And at the end of his life, we probably can add these words to the obituary, to be continued, for there's more to come. For our Lord Jesus assured his disciples that this eternal structure was in the process of being built. That is, in John's Gospel, chapter 14, he offered these comforting words. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I'm going to prepare then a place for you. And there is plenty room. But before we get there, what do we do with our lives while still living in our temporal home? We make best the gifts and skills that we have, and we offer them to the goodness of others. Ambrose did this in his own way. While delivering a document to someone, I mentioned that I had this funeral to be part of today. Not knowing that the gentleman knew Ambrose, he said, "He is a very nice person. I have worked with him." And I said, "But you were never, oh, you worked with him." He said, "While he was in the mortar pool in the BDF, we worked because of the cars and jeeps were insured by the company. And as the supervisor, we had to have interactions with the insuring of the trucks when there were accidents. And I found him always to be very efficient, timely, and polite. He probably never knew that the gentleman was thinking that of him. My brothers and sisters, the service that we offer is an opportunity for us to give of our best. And so this morning, as we come to say goodbye and thanks, It is the opportunity for us to stop and revisit our life, to think of its frailty, and not only to do that, but to refocus, and in refocusing, to prepare ourselves for the pitching of our own tent for the final time. Soldiers will tell you that when they are on maneuver, some of the things that they like to talk about, and certainly I would know when we were out camping, some of the things we would talk about is that we can't wait to get back home and have a proper bath, to lie in our comfortable beds, and to eat some good home-cooked meal. And those who wanted something a little stronger, not the Holy Spirit, would say, and to have a good drink. How glad they were to get back to the real world. The misery and hardship that they endured made homecoming all the sweeter. Our problem is that we often think, my brothers and sisters, that this tent that we're living in is the real world. It is not. What we are experiencing is but a shadow of reality. We, as my brother did, knew that one day we will have to move from the shadow lands of life and to encounter the reality of death. But today, God does not want for us to be afraid, but rather offers the confidence and assurance that when our earthly existence is over, we will leave our tent and dwell forever in our permanent home. This life is only life we know, but there's another life to come. The question for us, how are we preparing for it? Death is merely a transition in life. It is like getting orders for a new assignment. We who remain are left then today with sorrow. But may we find comfort in the certainty of reunion and rest. We who remain grieve, but we do so with hope. For to be absent from the body, this temporary tent, is to be at home with the Lord. So then, let us pay special attention to how we use our tent, what we do with our tent, and how we will strike our tent. This earthly journey gives us the opportunity to use our gifts and skills for the betterment of others. And even though not perfect, Ambrose did his best. It is for us now to do ours. May God's promises be the measurement of our hope. And may we, as we say goodbye, not be overcome by loss or drowned in hopelessness. But may we draw on the strength which is ours. For Jesus said, "Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of time." And so within these sacred walls, like others, we come to give God thanks and to receive from him the strength needed to go forward. To my sister from the same place, and to the daughter, find your comfort in Christ Jesus. Allow him to soothe you, to take you beside the still waters, and to know that through the good or bad times, the memories stay with you, and nothing can erase that. To Cheryl and all the other family members, we offer you the same condolences. And to those of us who are still in service, and those of us who have retired but still have not retired, God promises that he will sustain us. We will hold the fort. Even though the battle is hard today, we will hold the fort, for our Master Chief is coming. See his flag waving, saying to us, I am still with you until that time when you too strike your tent. And to my friend, there's a sacredness in tears. They're not the mark of weakness, but of power. They speak more eloquently than 10,000 tongues. They are the messengers of overwhelming grief, of deep sorrow, and an unspeakable love and respect. Until we meet again, farewell, my brother and friend. The word of God for the people of God. Amen.
Let us now stand as we, with confidence and hope, confess the faith into which we were baptized, as we say the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
We pray for those who mourn, especially the Deane family. We commemorate the departed, Ambrose Harrell. After each petition, your response is, hear our prayer. Let us pray with confidence to God our Father, who raised our Lord Jesus from the dead for the salvation of all. Grant, Lord, that your servant may know the fullness of life which you have promised to those who love you. Lord, in your mercy, be close to those who mourn. Increase their faith in your undying love. Lord, in your mercy, may we be strengthened in our faith. Live the rest of our lives in fellowship with your Son, and be ready when you call us to the fullness of life. Lord, in your mercy, show your mercy to the dying. Strengthen them with hope, and fill them with the peace and joy of your presence. Lord, in your mercy, we commend all people to your unfailing love, that in them your will may be fulfilled, and we rejoice at the faithful witness of your saints in every age, praying that we share with them in your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Let us now commend our brother. Give rest, O Christ, to your servant with your saints. You only are immortal, the creator and maker of mankind, and we are mortal, form of the earth, and to earth shall we return. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, power, and glory, forever.
Let us commend our brother Ambrose Harold to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant, Ambrose, O Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set him free from every bond, that he may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitation, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit, you live and reign one God forever and ever. Amen. Into your hands, O merciful Savior, we commend your servant Ambrose. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive Ambrose into the arms of your mercy, in the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light. Amen.
During the singing of the next hymn, a collection will be taken. The hymn number 757, When Peace Like a River Attendeth My Way.
Thank you.
songs yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. And all of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams yet to come true.
You can do them one after one. Right. When we finish, you can carry on playing after that.
Right, so when you first want to start, I'll just let them play.
Yes.
Thank you.
Okay. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me. He who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies through his indwelling spirit. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. You will show me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ. Henceforth, says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds. Man, born of a woman, has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he flees and never stays. In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can you turn for help but to you, Lord, who are justly angered by our sins? Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of eternal death. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at our last hour, let us not fall away from you.
Ensuring certain hope and resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. We commend to Almighty God our brother Ambrose Harold, and we commit his body to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor, that when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this, our brother Ambrose, and we ourselves may be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Almighty God, with whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, with all who have died in the true faith of your holy name, have perfect fulfillment and bliss in your eternal and everlasting glory, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the death of sin to the life of righteousness, that, when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our Mediator and Redeemer. Amen. Amen. Grant, O Lord, to all who are bereaved the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the days to come with steadfastness and patience, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness, and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Rest eternal grant to him, O Lord. May he and all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace. The Lord bless him and keep him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up his countenance upon him and give him peace. Amen.
kindly note. Kindly note the hymns will proceed unannounced.
in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come.
Let us pray. O God, the maker and redeemer of all mankind, grant us with your servant Ambrose and all the faithful departed the sure benefit of your Son's saving passion and glorious resurrection, that in the last day when you gather up all things in Christ, we may with them enjoy the fullness of your promises, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now unto God's gracious mercy I commit you this day. May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon you and give you his peace now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
In the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. And all of my hopes, all of my plans, my heart and my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer you my life. Things in the past, things yet unseen, wishes and dreams that are yet to come true. All of my hopes, all of my plans, my hands are lifted to you. Lord, I offer my life to you. Everything I've been through, use it for your glory. Lord, I offer my days to you, lifting my praise. Pleasing sacrifice, Lord, I offer you my life. Lord, I offer my life.
is given.